ஆண்டாள் திருவடிகளே சரணம். திருப்பாவை 9th பாசுரம். தூமணி மாடத்து சுற்றும் விளக்கெரிய தூபம் கமழ துயிலனை மேல் கண் வளரும் மாமான் மகளே மணிக்கதவம் தாழ்த்திரவாய் மாமீரவளை எழுப்பீரோ உன் மகள் தான் உமையோ அன்றி செவிடோ அனந்தலோ ஏமப்பெருந்துயில் மந்திரப்பட்டாளோ மாமா என் மாதவன் வைகுந்தனென்றென்று நாமம் பலவும் நவின்றேலோரெம்பாவாய். ஆண்டாள் அண்ட் ஹர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் ப்ரொசீடிங் ஃபார் த பாவை நோம்பு அண்ட் நாட் டு லீவ் அவுட் எனி ஆஃப் ஹர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ். ஆண்டாள் மேக்ஸ் அன் அட்டெம்ப்ட் டு கோ டு தி ஹவுசஸ் ஆஃப் தி ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் ஹூ ஹவ் நாட் கம், வேக் தெம் அப் அண்ட் டேக் தெம் அலாங் டு ஹர் குரூப் டு டூ த பாவை நோம்பு. ஸோ டில் நவு ஷி ஹஸ் வோக்கன் அப் 3 ஆஃப் ஹர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் டுடே she is proceeding to the house of the fourth friend in the 9th pasuram. It seems that this girl is a very rich girl and her house is very beautiful. As Aandaal reaches her house, the beauty of the house captures Aandaal's eyes, and so she starts describing this girl who is inside this beautiful house, inside her beautiful room. Aandaal starts the pasuram saying தூமணி மாடத்து. இட் சீம்ஸ் தி ஹவுஸ் ஆஃப் திஸ் கேர்ள் அண்ட் ஹர் ரூம் ஆர் ஆல் டெக்கரேட்டட் வித் ப்ரைஸ்லெஸ் ஜெம்ஸ். அண்ட் ஹவ் ஆர் தீஸ் ஜெம்ஸ்? தே ஆர் ஆல் ஃப்ளாலெஸ் ஜெம்ஸ். இட் இஸ் நோன் வெரி வைட்லி தட் மெனி ஜெம்ஸ் கேன் ஹாவ் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் கைண்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஃப்ளாஸ் அண்ட் சம்டைம்ஸ் வி கேன் கெட் ரிட் ஆஃப் தீஸ் ஃப்ளாஸ் அண்ட் மேக் தி ஜெம் யூஸ்ஃபுல். But some gems naturally come without any flaws, and such gems are called as dosha rahitam or flawless. It seems such flawless gems were used to make the pillars, the floors and the roof of this girl's house. So these flawless gems attract the attention of Aandaal. Why are these attracting the attention of Aandaal? Because Aandaal knows about this Gopika. This Gopika, this friend of Aandaal, is flawless herself. She is absolutely pure at heart. So everything associated with her is also maintained pure by her, including the mundane materialistic aspects that she has surrounding her, like her house or like a pillar in the house or any aspect, anything that she uses for her daily use. So she's maintaining everything in the purest form, in the most flawless form. And Aandaal makes a mention of it when she says, "Thoomani maadathu." And inside this flawlessly made house, she has a wonderful ambience. An ambience which is made with decorated lamps. Sutrum vilakkeriya. Number of lamps are mildly shining and looking very, very beautiful. Again, lamps are a sign of auspiciousness, and Aandaal, being Mangala Devata and singing the Mangala Prabandham of ThiruppAvai, always makes mention of Mangala or auspicious things. And this lamp lighting is a similar aspect. Not only lamps, but also fragrant sticks of dhoop are lit in this room of this friend. Dhoopam kamala, wonderful fragrance is coming out from them. And amidst this pleasant ambience, this girl is happily sleeping on her soft bed. Thuilanai mel kanvalarum. Her bed is so inviting, it seems, that even if someone were suffering from insomnia or someone is not interested in sleeping, if they look at that bed, they would definitely go to sleep. It was so inviting and cozy. And on this cozy bed, this friend of hers lay very, very happily and content. It seems this girl had such a satisfactory look on her face that she seemed to have everything in life. Such was the contentment seen. And looking at this contentment, Aandaal was very, very impressed. Why was this gopi sleeping so happily and so peacefully? It was because she had complete trust on the Lord. She did not worry about going and doing something for the Lord or going and attaining Him or something. She was completely relaxed because she knew that she wanted to attain the Lord and the Lord would pave some way for it. She had that supreme confidence called Mahavishwasam on the Lord. And this quality of this friend really appealed to Andal and she became very appreciative of her. So in appreciation of this girl, Andal actually wanted to establish a relationship with her. She wanted to make this girl a family member of hers. So she called out to this girl as Maman Magale. Maman Magale refers to uncle's daughter, cousin. Andal says that I wish this girl were my cousin. So let me make her my cousin. Let me call out to her as a cousin. It's all in the mind to make a relationship. So in my mind, I think of this girl's father as my mama, my uncle. And this girl thus becomes my cousin. Because I want a cousin like her. She's so sweet. She trusts the Lord so much. I just love this quality of this girl. So I want to make her my relative, Andal feels. And she calls out to her as Maman Magale. But this cousin, this Maman Magal, is so engrossed in her confidence on the Lord that she's not able to hear anything that these girls are saying. She is sleeping peacefully, unaware of what is happening in the surroundings. But as Andal is calling out, her friends who have come along with her are also calling out to the girl. And this noise makes this girl's mother come out from the house. And this mother now starts talking to Andal and her friends. So Andal addresses this girl's mother as Mamir. Mamir means aunt. Aunt, please wake up your daughter, they say. And the friends of Andal are now a little worried for the girl. They ask this aunt as to whether her daughter is dumb or something. Can't she reply to us? We are talking so much. Can't she say a single word in reply? Mami run magalai eluppiro. Un magal taan umayo. Is she dumb? Umayo, they ask. To this, the mother answers, absolutely not. My daughter is a chatterbox. She keeps on talking. I have to tell her to keep quiet. Oh, these girls say. Then she must be definitely deaf. Sevido. What? You say my daughter is deaf? Says the mother. Absolutely not. She can hear even ultrasonic sounds like the bat. She can hear everything. She has absolute sharp ears. Have no doubt about it. Then the girls proceed to say, then we are sure of one thing, auntie. She must be a lazy, lethargic, and aloof-natured girl. Anandalo, they say. To this, the aunt does not answer. So, these girls understand that the girl sleeping inside is lazy. Then Andal explains to her other friends that, yes, this girl is lazy, but she is lazy to these worldly pleasures and other things. She is not lazy towards going to the Lord. She has extreme trust on the Lord, so she is sleeping. Alvar say that lazy people are of two types. One kind of lazy people are the ones who lose everything and become losers. And the other kind of lazy people are winners of the Lord. They win over the laziness of the world and go to the Lord. They are called as the winning lazy people or Vaalum Somber. Thondaradi Podi Alvar says in his Thirumalai that devotees are Vaalum Somber, means they are the winning lazy lot. So this girl is somebody who belongs to the winning lazy lot. She is Anandalo, but she has the right kind of laziness. She does not want to indulge in unnecessary activities of the world. She only wants to enjoy the Lord and she is sure that the Lord will grant her this enjoyment. But then, when we are calling out to this girl, we are also calling her for divine experience. So wouldn't it be great if she comes and joins us and tells us how to build Mahavishwasam or supreme trust on the Lord? So it's essential that she gets up. And again, these girls try to wake her up, for which the girl again gives no response. So the friends of Andal now have a different kind of doubt. They are thinking that probably this girl has been hypnotized with some spell. They ask the girl's mother as to whether somebody has cast some spell or some mantra on her. Has she started sleeping for a long, long time because of some spell? Mandira pattalo, they ask. To this, the girl's mother becomes very, very startled and answers that you girls must not be talking like this. I have a girl who's of marriageable age, and if you start speaking of some spell being cast on her, how will I find a suitable groom for her? You are actually complicating the situation too much, and I don't think you must be speaking like this. Please do not talk like this, the mother says. And then she also gets carried away and scared that whether her daughter is really under some spell, because she is answering to nothing. And despite so much noise happening in the surrounding, she's not responding at all. So the mother also gets scared and starts asking Andal as to if she has some remedy for some spell. And Andal replies very beautifully to her mother that, do not worry, auntie. I don't think your daughter is under any bad spell. She is under the spell of having confidence on the Lord. And to break this spell, I have a beautiful remedy or a counter spell. What is that? We need to chant some mantra. She is under the caste of some mantra, and that mantra is nothing but Mahavishwasa on the Lord. And to do away with this spell or to arouse her from this slumber so that she can transfer or teach us this teaching of Mahavishwasa, I have another mantra, she says. What is that mantra? Namam palavum navinre lorembavai. We can chant the thousand names of the Lord. Namam palavum navinre. The Vishnu Sahasranama of the Lord is the mantra by which your daughter will get up and teach us the mantra by which she has become a wonderful devotee of the Lord in the right manner that one should be. So, let us all start chanting the Vishnu Sahasranama, which has great names like Mamayan Madhavan Vaigundanendrendre. There are beautiful names in the Vishnu Sahasranama which talk about the Lord being Mamayan. Mamayan refers to the one who can perform deeds which cannot be performed by anybody else, the unparalleled one. And Madhavan refers to that consort of Lakshmi who is capable of doing things which cannot be done by anybody else. Why is the Lord Mamayan? Why is he able to do something that nobody else can do? Because he is the consort of Ma, Lakshmi, and thus he is Madhava. And because he is Madhava, he is also Vaikuntha, the Lord who resides in Sri Vaikuntha, the supreme boss of the universe. So all such names and more are present in the Vishnu Sahasranama. Let us go ahead, chant it and wake this girl up from her slumber so that she can come and join our group and give us her wisdom-laden teachings. Hearing this, this girl gets up from her sleep and comes and joins Andal Goshti.